But let us now assume that everybody working on this network, everybody is complaining. So definitely we must know that the problem is what is from the server. So in that case, this type of network is very easy to troubleshoot. Then another advantage is that no disruptions to network when connecting or removing devices. What we mean by this is that when adding more computers to the network, activities of other users will not be affected. For example, let us assume that we want to connect another computer to this network now through this side. It doesn't mean that we have to ask the users of the remaining system to log out so that we can now connect more computers to the network. No, because each computer can be connected directly to the server. Likewise, when we are removing any computer from this network, if we want to disconnect any computer from this network, the activities of other users will not be affected at all And that's a great advantage. Take for instance, if you go to Cyber Cafe to browse and you want to disconnect one computer from the network, experienced a situation whereby the person in charge will say everybody log out simply because we want to disconnect one computer from the network, or because we want to connect more computer to the network, now say everybody should log out? No, because each computer will have direct access to the server. Another advantage is that information is available for all users on a central database. The network server here will serve as the central database. So which means that the information needed by all the users, that if at the terminals connected to it, they are available on this central server. So which means that any computer that has access to this server will be able to benefit from that particular data or facilities. Then easier to address each computer and the network by central server. It will be very easy for the server to be able to address each computer on the network. Why? Because each computer on this network will have an ID that can easily be traced or that can easily be located through the server. So in that case, it will be very easy to actually address any computer on that server, whether the user or the server want to communicate with a particular terminal on the network. Is very easy simply because each of these computers will have direct contact or connection to the server. Now, star topology, it has some disadvantages. One, high dependence of the system on the functioning of the central server. What happened now is that the moment the central server failed, the entire network will collapse, and which means that all the computer connected to the server, they will depend 100% on the server. Then another thing now is that failure of the central hub. What we mean by central hub is the central server. Sometimes we can call it central host. That is, failure of the central hub or server renders the network useless. That is, when we are working on a network, and we now experience a situation whereby the server is down, it means all the terminals connected to that server will not be able to do anything, because whatever they want to do, it must be through the server. So in that case, if that server is having a problem, it means the activities of other users will be affected. Then the performance and scalability of the network depends on the capabilities of the hub or server. What we are saying here is that the number of computers that will be on the network that will be connected to the server, that is the number of terminals or computers, that will be connected together, that will be connected to the server, will depend on the capability of the server. So what you are saying now is, let us assume that we are using a server that can effectively carry 20 computers, and we now decide to connect about 25 or 30 computers to it. It means we will have a problem when we are working on that network, simply because we have exceeded the capacity of the power server, and what you are going to experience is that the network will be very, very slow, And that case, if you are using it for business, user will definitely, I mean, will be complaining because we have exceeded the what, the capacity. So what happened now is that when we set up this type of topology, it doesn't mean that we can now continue to connect as many computers as possible to the central server. We have to check the capability of the central server in order to be able to know the maximum number of computers that can work effectively on that network. Then another disadvantage is that network size is limited by the number of connections that can be made to the server. This one is also similar to the previous to number three. Then the next thing is activities in the network are halted if the central server breaks down. Likewise, the number of stars or terminals, the number of stars or terminals is limited by the complexity of the central server. Now, we need to take note of something. When we are, anytime we are discussing the issue of network like this, terminals normally is a system connected to the server. This terminal can as well be called node. It can as well be called workstation. Then it can as well be called client. Can be called client. So that is why we always use those these terms or terminologies interchangeably. Ring topology. A ring topology is a network topology in which each node connects to exactly two other nodes, forming a single continuous pathway for signals or data through each node, which will eventually form a ring. So computers in the network are arranged in series around a ring. Messages are passed from one workstation to another until the destination is reached. Each computer may communicate with any other computer in the ring, and messages from one computer to the other must be specifically addressed to the destination computer. What you are saying here now is that a ring topology is a topology whereby each computer or terminal is connected directly to two computers in a continuous ring form. So what we are saying now is this. When we have a station whereby we have some computers that want to network, we can have as many computers as possible. But the way we are going to arrange the computers is going to be in circular form, like this. And from the definition, we said that it's a network whereby each computer will be connected directly to every other two computers. So if you have to start our connection from here, it means this parallel computer will be connected directly to this one. Then it will be connected directly to this one. So this one will be connected directly to this. Then directly to this. This one also, it will be connected directly to this. Then it will be connected directly to this. Then, likewise, this one will be connected directly to this. And finally, it will be connected directly to this one. So it will now form a ring. And that is why we say that it's a network, whereby each computer will be connected directly to every other two computers in a continuous ring form. So when we set up this type of network, it's not compulsory that we must have a server. But in the exam, anytime star topology is tested, we must indicate server. Likewise, tree topology. When we get to tree topology, we are going to look at it. But when it comes to ring topology, the most important thing the examiner will be looking for is the connection, not the server. Because topology does not have a problem with the server for its connectivity. So we just need to get a channel, that is, we just need to get something like cable, that is network cable, and now use it to interconnect the computers. But the computer must be arranged in circular form so that each computer will be connected directly to two other computers in a continuous ring form. But let us now assume that in the exam we just want to indicate server. What happens is that we just need to write server on any one of them. But as far as this one is concerned, even if you write server there, it will not fetch us a mark. Because what the examiner will be looking for is the way the computers are connected together, not the server. But if it is ring topology, if it is a star topology, we have to indicate server. But as far as ring topology is concerned, it's not all that necessary, because it has to do with the circular arrangement of computers on the network that has little or nothing to do with the server or its connectivity. Now, this topology has its own advantages and disadvantages. One, the first advantage is that data is evenly handled in the network and easy to add more computers in the ring. If we want to add more computers to the network, it's very easy to add. For example, now, let's come back to the diagram. If you want to connect another computer to this one, the only thing is just to put our computer here and get a cable and connect it to the main cable that connects all the computers together. So which means that it's very easy to do to connect. Then, very orderly network where every device has access to token and the opportunity to transmit. When we are talking about ring topology, every computer on that parallel network, in the network, has the opportunity to transmit data. Because if I decide to send data from this computer now to this computer, there is no way the data will not pass through some computers on the network, because it is only one network cable that connects all the computers together. So, which means that during data transmission, each computer on the network has the ability, or I mean, has the opportunity to transmit data. Now, another thing now is that it performs better than a bus topology. Under every network load, when there's every traffic, so it performs better compared to other topology, especially the bus topology. Then it does not require network server to manage the connectivity between computers. Ring topology does not have anything to do with server. So, but despite all these advantages, it also has disadvantages. One, identification of source of problem is not easy. If there is problem on that parallel network, it's not all that easy to identify or troubleshoot compared to the way we can easily identify problems in the ring star topology. Number two, network activities are held up when adding or removing a computer to or from the ring. That is, if we are to add more computer to this network or remove computer from this network, there is no way they will not tamper with the cable. And the moment we tamper with the cable, then there's no way data transmission can take place. So which means that if we decide to add more computer to this network through this side, it means other users will not be able to work on the network simply because we have to tamper with this cable. And that's why we say the activities of users will be granted or will be affected when adding more computer to the network or removing computer from the network. Then number three, one malfunctioning workstation or bad port can create problems for the entire network simply because each computer on the network has the opportunity to transmit data. Why? Because it's only one cable that connects all the computers together. So in a situation whereby one computer malfunction, so the data transmission may be affected. Then moves, hands, or changes of devices can affect the network. That is, frequent changes of devices on that parallel network can easily affect the network. Now, coming to bus topology, a bus topology uses common or single communication line or cable to connect the various workstations, servers, and other peripheral devices on the network. With this configuration, devices can be added or removed easily from the network. Messages sent from one node or terminal to another goes to every other nodes in the network at the same time. In order to simplify this parallel definition, now say, bus topology is a topology whereby all the computers in the network will be connected. All the computers in the network will be connected. To only one communication cable on a straight line. So what happened here is this. From this definition, let us quickly draw the diagram. So we have only one communication cable like this. The conditional is that that communication cable must be on a straight line. They will now begin to connect computers.